Do you believe that heating will melt your fillers? Let's see. So today we're talking about one of the most common questions in a training, especially if we're talking about devices. People say, how long after my filler can I have a device treatment? The most common ones, of course, radio frequency, lasers, IPL, which is a broad spectrum of light that's filtered. And then we have, of course, microneedling with radio frequency that's very common these days as well. So we'll talk about that whole realm of products and fillers. So hyaluronic acid fillers are typically, after they're made and before they get to us, have been heated and sterilized. So it's not going to dissolve or melt those products, hyaluronic acids. And then if you go to other products that we might consider fillers, such as calcium hydroxylapatite, PMMA like Belafil, or PLLA like Sculptra, Sculptra is a polymer, those and PMMA particularly, very high temperatures they can be subject to. It's not going to melt them, and of course it's not going to melt calcium. It doesn't melt your bone. And so it doesn't melt the product. And a lot of people say, well, when can I treat? It depends on a few factors because it's not that simple. And it's why your provider will determine the time after that you can have those treatments. First of all, if you microneedle, and they can go fairly deep now with radio frequency, the heating's not going to be the problem, but you are creating channels. And potentially, if you put a filler in and immediately after do that, theoretically, maybe before that filler can integrate with the tissue, it can move through those channels a little bit. We don't really see that. That's more of a theoretical problem. But that's why some people might wait a few weeks for integration to take place. A lot of products integrate differently over time, but that's sometimes 2 to 4 weeks. So that would be one reason that you might delay an injectable RF. Now, I just said that things like high frequency ultrasound and radio frequency, they're not going to melt it either. They get to about 60 degrees max, and fillers can take up to 120 degrees. And so if you look at lasers like CO2, then you're up near 100 degrees ablative lasers. Even those don't reach it. However, the caveat is some of these devices also have suction and massage. And I think that plays a role. Because we know from 15, 20 years ago, when we didn't quite know, do we massage these or do we not, or do we massage them? If people did that, oftentimes, especially using that bolus technique, they'd come back in a few weeks and see nothing. The filler never went away, it just dispersed. So some of these radio frequency machines, it's not that we believe it's going to dissolve it, but the massage or the vibration or the needles might disperse it. Heat first. Relax them for 15 minutes, let them cool down, do the fillers, and it won't affect the Botox either, but do the Botox and fillers after, do the threads after. And at that point, then it gives you another six weeks to 3 months before you need to redo any of those products. So I hope that helps give a better understanding of it, but just purely heating over these products will not melt, dissolve, or remove them. What do you think? What's your experience been with it? Let us know below. Join us also over on Instagram to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.